My name is Mike Greer. I work for the Michigan Department of Transportation Statewide Maintenance. I'm a licensed heating and air conditioning and boiler installer. Today, we are at the Grand Ledge rest area just west of Lansing. This is a newly constructed rest area. What we're going to show you today are some new ideas about building a green, energy efficient building. Probably one of the first things I want to show you is domestic storage tanks. In our older rest areas, storage tank, expansion tanks, we used to have 3 to 4 storage tanks per building that were approximately 3 to 4 foot in diameter, 6.5 foot tall. That would take up a large amount of our room. What we've gone to is a freak drive well pump. The speed of the motor increases as the pressure in the building drops. So you could almost have that pump just barely turning, but supplying enough water for the building. What you're looking at here is a heating manifold for the in-floor heat of a new rest area. And we've gone to the in-floor heat because it's even, it's energy efficient, it's safer in the sense that when these people get in here and clean this floor, it dries just like that. When we have the snow and the moisture and it's being tracked into the lobby, that moisture is drying with this in-floor heat and we have a clean, safe environment then. Another thing that you'll notice in these new rest areas is the floor itself. Concrete below, but on top of this, they've gone to a epoxy sealant, wear like iron, lasts forever. This is a typical men's toilet room. Maybe not the most glamorous thing to talk about, but these are the men's urinals. These are water-free urinals. Typical savings, as advertised, 40,000 gallons of water per year. They're clean, they're safe, and they work. What you're looking at here is a typical rest area line of sinks with water and soap dispensers. And the energy savings here that we're seeing is that people, when they walk away, because they're automatic faucets, they shut off. You don't have somebody come in, leave the faucet running, and walk away. Each toilet room has its own exhaust fan. When somebody walks in this toilet room, that exhaust fan is energized. And when they leave and nobody else is in here, it shuts off. In the past, we have left these exhaust fans running constantly. There's a huge savings there. What we're looking at here are the 2 geothermal heat pumps that we are presently installing in the new rest areas. What we do is we take a closed loop and we run it outside. We're trying to absorb the energy, the heat from the ground. We're trying to transfer that heat to the building. And I want to first get away from a misconception that we are taking water from the ground, absorbing the heat from it, and then rejecting it, pump and dump. We don't do that here in this rest area. It is a sealed system. We are not using any water from the ground. If you could look at your household air conditioner, you're absorbing heat from the inside and you're transferring it to the outside. We're kind of doing the reverse. We're absorbing the heat from the earth and we're transferring it to the building through the refrigeration cycle on a closed loop. Nothing is transferring except for the heat. This is our geothermal water storage tank. From this tank, we supply hot water to the in-floor heat and to the hot water domestic storage tank. For me as a mechanic, one of the best things that I like about this geothermal from a safety standpoint is I don't have to worry about 2 boilers sitting here supplied with natural gas or propane, and I have something that's combustible in this building that's not always attended. Another improvement we've made in these rest areas is when you walk into the lobby, a nice comfortable atmosphere. And another item is the LED lighting. Our lighting is more cost efficient. I know a lot of ideas, meetings, exchanging of thoughts go into making these buildings appealing and energy efficient for the motoring public and the taxpayer.